Let's look at planning for cost centers. Let's look at why you need to use planning. Planning is a function available in the CU module. You can use this planning function to assign plan values for cost centers, internal orders, profitability segments, and so on. In this presentation, we look at planning for cost centers. We ran some of our cost center reports earlier and we saw the actual plan variance reports, whereas we only had values in the actual columns. Now in the system, you can also put plan values in the system for cost centers against different cost elements. So you'll be saying, for example, a GL account, an expense account like 501000, which might be an office supplies expense account, you can put a plan value saying for this particular cost center, use $12,000. And you can divide that equally for 12 months for $1,000 each, or you can put your own amount as well for different months. So why you need to use planning is because companies, they initially set up the budgets for different years. For example, for next year, they will already plan the budgets 3 to 6 months ahead, saying this is our planned budget for next year. And this budgeting is done for the income statement. It's usually not done for balance sheet statement. It's done for income statement, because income statement is a periodical statement, whereas the balance sheet statement is for, as of today, your current balance sheet amounts. That's again going towards, more towards technically towards the financial accounting module. But planning is usually done for the income statement, that is against all your revenues and expenses. So you set up your budgets for revenues and expenses throughout your whole organization, and that is broken down into different departments. This can be a top-down approach or a bottom-up approach. For example, many divisions, they will plan their own divisional budgets and give it to the organization, and organization will consolidate all the budgets together and arrive at the overall company's budgeted amount for the next fiscal year. The second option is the top-down approach, whereas the company decides this is my budget for the next fiscal year, and then they give it to the different departments and break it down the amounts. So whichever way you want to use, you need to put the planning amounts for different cost centers. That's your departments and divisions are going to become cost centers in the system, and all your budgeted accounts, which is going to become like cost elements. That's mostly going to be your expense account. For cost center accounting, we usually do planning for expense accounts. That is your cost element account with the cost element category number one. These are all your primary cost element accounts, which are your expense accounts. You put plan values against them for cost centers. If you want to do revenue planning, it's usually done at the profit center level, or it's also done at the profitability segment level. For different products, you can plan for different values, and there's more towards the revenue planning done. In this presentation, we'll only look at doing planning for expenses, specifically for cost centers. You also have the functionality to do planning for internal orders. Now, early in some of our presentations, we saw we put budget amounts for internal orders, which actually controls how much you can specifically spend for an internal order. You have the option of putting a plan value, which is different from a budget value, whereas a plan value just gives an analysis only against actual and plan and gives a variance. So if you do not want to put a budgeted amount for internal order, but you still want to put a plan value for a small marketing campaign, saying that for this marketing campaign we'll put a plan value of $1,000, you can go ahead and put that for an internal order. So that's different from a budget amount, is that budget will actually control of how much you can spend. Plan values are purely used for analysis. All the planning you do follows for a cost center, for a type of cost element, you can always exceed that amount. There's no, system will not restrict that, because it's purely done for analysis purpose. And this is very useful for the company also, because they can do quarterly analysis or monthly analysis and see how the departments are doing against their actual planned amounts, whether they're exceeding the budget or going under budget and so on. Now let's try to do some planned entries in the system for cost center accounting. The SAP menu path to enter plan values for cost center accounting is accounting, controlling, cost center accounting, planning, cost and activity inputs, and this is the short transaction code KP06. So let's execute this transaction. And you'll come across this screen. So for version, we'll enter 0 because that's the default plan version. the one really comes up over here, and this is